Dear students, a third characteristic when we consider joint distribution is covariance. If we are considering only one random variable, the two characteristics of importance are expected value and variance. When we consider more than one, that is when we consider joint distribution, the two characteristics which we are interested are covariance and the correlation coefficients. Suppose that we have two random variables x with the expected x is equal to mu x and y with the expected y equal to mu y. Two random variables with the expected values given as mu x and mu y. Then the covariance x y can be written as expected value of x minus ex into y minus ey can also be written as expected value of x minus mu x, because ex is mu x, into y minus mu y. Expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. That is the notation for covariance, denoted as covariance xy, can also be written as sigma xy. Covariance denoted by the notation sigma xy, covariance xy denoted as sigma xy is equal to expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. And if x and y are independent, as we have, and so expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. Now let me consider an expansion of this expression. The expansion can be written like this: expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y can be written as expected value of xy minus x into mu y minus y into mu x plus mu x mu y. When expectation is taken inside, it becomes expected xy minus expected x mu x mu y, mu y mu x, and is equal to mu x and mu y are constants, mu x mu y. Expected xy minus mu x mu y. That is the formula for covariance. And we, as we have already stated, if x and y are independent, expected value of xy is equal to mu x into mu y, or expected x into expected y, that is mu x into mu y. So substituting the value, the covariance becomes mu x mu y minus mu x mu y equal to 0. So very important result. If two random variables are independent, then the covariance is 0. But the converse is not true. Suppose that the covariance between two random variables is, covariance between two random variables is 0. That does not mean that the random variables are independent. This is because covariance is a measure of linear association only. Now suppose that we have a relation like this, y is equal to x square. Here, covariance between x and y is equal to 0. covariance between x and y is equal to 0 because the association between y and x is not linear. But y and x are related. They are non-linearly related. So if x and y are two independently distributed random variables, the covariance is 0. Zero covariance does not mean that the random variables are independent. It may be that they are not linearly related. But there is an exception to this rule. If x and y are two normally distributed random variables, that is a point which we will see later. If x and y are two normally distributed random variables, then zero covariance always imply statistical independence. So there is an exception to the rule. The rule is if the random variables y and x are independent, zero covariance means statistical independence. This is true only in the case of normally distributed random variables. This will not hold generally in the case of all the random variables. Now this is covariance. And if x and y are two discrete random variables, covariance xy is computed as sigma sigma xy double summation x minus mu x into y minus mu y fx fy. If x and y are discrete random variables, can be written as fx in not fx into fy f of xy, the joint distribution, that is sigma sigma x minus mu x into y minus mu y fxy. If x and y are discrete random variables, if they are continuous, the formula is integral minus infinity to plus infinity, integral double integral plus integrity xy fxy dx dy. If x and y are continuous random variables, these are the computational formulas. This is the standard notation for covariance sigma xy, expected value of x minus mu x ex y minus ey. Ex and ey represented by mu x and mu y. This can be written like this. And if x and y are two independently distributed random variables, covariance become 0. This is given from this proof. And covariance is a quantity of importance and extensively used in econometric analysis. Now let us see what are the properties of covariance. We have already discussed some of these properties already. So this is only a repeat. This is a repetition. Now, if x and y are two independently distributed random variables, covariance xy is equal to 0. This is because we have written the covariance xy as equal to expected value of xy minus mu x mu y. And also that if x and y are independently distributed, this becomes ex into ey or mu x mu y minus mu x mu y equal to 0. So covariance is 0. If x and y are two independently distributed random variables, then covariance ax by is equal to covariance ax by is equal to ab covariance xy. AB covariance xy. Then covariance a plus bx, a plus bx, c plus dy is equal to covariance. A plus bx, c plus dy is equal to bd covariance xy. Because a and c are constants. And using this bd, ad, a plus bx, bd covariance xy. These are some of the properties. Then covariance x plus a y plus b is equal to covariance x y. Covariance x plus a y plus b covariance x y. Then covariance between x and x is equal to variance of x. Covariance xx is equal to variance x. And covariance so these properties are enough for our purpose. So this covariance and some of the properties of covariance required for our purpose. There are many other properties, and we will use in our analysis these properties. That is the third important characteristics which we consider in our analysis when we consider more than one random variable, that is covariance. Another characteristics which we consider is the population correlation coefficients. Population correlation coefficients. Another characteristics which we use extensively is the population correlation coefficients denoted as rho. And the sample counterparties are which we are familiar with. So rho. Rho is written as is equal to covariance xy divided by root of variance x into root of variance y. Covariance xy divided by root of variance x into root of variance y. Now correlation coefficients, as I told you in a previous class, is a measure of linear association between variables. Is a measure of linear association between variables. And remember this, as we have stated earlier, correlation coefficient will be positive, negative, or zero depending on the value of covariance. The purpose of dividing it with the variances is to make it a unitless number. So if correlation is a measure of linear association, it is because covariance is a measure of linear association. So zero covariance does not mean statistical dependence. As I told you earlier, variables will be non-linearly related. One exception is the case of normally distributed random variables. Now, using the notations, we have written covariance xy as covariance xy root of variance x sigma x into sigma y. So covariance xy can be written as rho into sigma x sigma y. Covariance xy can also be written as rho into sigma x sigma y. Now using the standard notations we have introduced, rho can be written like this. C equal to, and as we have stated earlier, covariance xy is equal to expected value of x minus ex into y minus ey divided by root of expected value of x minus ex, x minus ex the whole square into root of expected value of y minus ey the whole square. This is the standard notation for population correlation coefficients. Covariance xy divided by root of variance x into root of variance y. Since covariance xy was written as sigma xy, we can write sigma xy as equal to rho into sigma x into sigma y. Correlation coefficient is extensively used in econometric analysis. The range of rho, population correlation coefficient, is between plus 1 and minus 1. The range of rho is between plus 1 and minus 1. If rho is plus 1, perfect to positive correlation, minus 1, perfect to negative correlation, 0 means no correlation. Now, and the value lie between minus 1 and plus 1. Now let us see some of the properties of what is known as some of the properties of the variances of sum of random variables. Is a repetition of what we have already studied. Only a repetition, just to reconsider some of the points we have considered earlier. That is, one is variance x plus y is equal to, as we have written earlier, variance x plus variance y plus 2 covariance xy, 2 covariance xy and variance. So this can be written as variance x plus variance y plus 2 sigma xy, because covariance xy is written as sigma xy. Variance x plus variance y plus 2 covariance 2 variance 2 covariance was written as rho into sigma x. Similarly, variance x minus y is equal to variance x plus variance y minus 2 rho sigma xy, x minus y. If x and y are independent, variance x plus or minus y is equal to variance x plus variance y, because the covariance term will disappear, like that. Now, so we have introduced expectation, variance, covariance, and also correlation coefficients. Now, two other quantities which we extensively used in econometrics is conditional expectation and conditional variance. And we have already introduced the conditional expectation in the context of population regression function and stated that conditional expectation, expected y given x is equal to, expected y given x is equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 xi. Since we have already introduced what is conditional expectation, I am not repeating the same here. This is conditional expectation. Expected y, if the conditional distribution is given, conditional expectation can always be calculated as beta 1 plus beta 2 xi. Similarly, conditional variance. So these are the characteristics of random variables over probability density function of the random variables. Now there is, let me consider one more point in this context. Let us, we have defined x as a random variable. Let us see how we standardize this random variable. X is a random variable with the mean mu and variance sigma square. Now define a variable x minus mu by sigma. Now this quantity is known as the standardized variable because let it be defined as a new variable y is equal to x minus mu by sigma. Now expected y is equal to 1 by sigma into expected value of x minus mu is equal to expected value of x is mu, mu minus mu, so 0. And variance of x is, variance of y is equal to 1 by sigma square into variance of x minus mu is equal to 1 by sigma square into variance of x is sigma square, variance of mu is 0, is equal to 1. So, for a standardized variable, mean is 0 and the variance is 1. That means we can convert all the random variables into standard normal variables by using two adjustments. These adjustments are, one, we change the origin from mean to 0. Subtracting a mean is changing the origin. And we divide this with the standard deviation. And dividing with the standard deviation means changing the scale. The scale is changed from sigma square to 1. So any normal variable, any random variable can be standardized by changing the origin and the scale. And about this, we will consider extensively later. That is, from if x is normal, z is standard normal, this standardization is obtained by changing the scale and also changing the origin.